I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
How you feeling, Fernando? First of all, your arms look like you're ready to make a comeback and fight Fury, Joshua, or Wilder.
I only fight with my wife.
But look at those guns. You've been working out?
Before I used to be an alcoholic. Now I just lift every day, Monday through Friday. That's it. I don't go to the gyms on the weekends. Saturdays to be with my family. Sundays to be with the Lord, and that's it.
I talked to Robert Garcia about you and the Big G the other day. They said no one is ferocious as Feroz. What made you so great as a fighter, Fernando?
Having people like El Señor Eduardo Garcia in my corner. Without him, I wouldn't have been nothing. So I'm grateful. I'm always going to be grateful to the Garcia family, my compadre Roberto, we're going to be baptized my second son, Amado. So, Amado Malvado, Fernando Vargas. So, you know, the Vargas, you know, bloodline's coming. It's continue to produce fruit. And, you know, my third son's number one in the nation, a three-time national champion. My second son, Amado, started late, but he's doing great. So, you know, he's going to continue working hard and, you know, 20, 30 more fights, and then I'm going to turn a pro.
That's amazing. I want to show you a poster they're putting up in the gym. Your son looks just like you. Hold on, let's find that poster. Where did it go? It's a poster. Look, you, Robert, and Chavez Sr. You guys look... Doesn't that look like your son?
It looks like all my beans.
They look... Layman, what can you tell us about Fernando? You guys were teammates on the U.S. You guys were teammates.
Yeah.
He was like the normal leader of the group.
Yeah, and he was like the Tasmanian devil. I was just saying, listen, you know what? As long as I walk this earth, I'm always going to be telling people about how this dude almost got us killed
in Argentina.
Everybody know this story. This is the greatest story ever. Because,
tell people the story one more time.
Okay, so we are in Argentina, right? He's a young, pretty boy.
He's
still pretty. Look.
He's vicious.
So he was one of the few people on the team that actually spoke Spanish, even though they speak Portuguese. It's kind of the same.
They speak Spanish.
Yeah. I thought it was Portuguese.
That's Brazil.
Yeah, no, Portuguese.
That's even worse.
Okay.
So no wonder they wanted to kill us.
Argentina.
He knew what he was doing. So what he was trying to do, right? He was trying to get us murdered. So we had a guy fighting in the ring.
They were just disrespecting us. They were just disrespecting us.
See that? I said get us killed. Because you have to understand, when you are an ant in a bee's nest, you don't act like you tough. This dude right here.
He's been tough his whole life.
Yeah, but that ain't the point. They almost got us killed. So we're in the ring. We had a fighter in the ring, right? And I'm the team captain. So my job is, you know, keep us all together. We supporting a fighter. Well, he's sitting like sort of right behind us, and he keep turning his head back to the crowd. They speaking Spanish, he speaking Spanish. They speaking Spanish, we speaking Spanish. I don't know what is going on, but all I know, as soon as the fight ended, it's just like you see how loud it is in here and everybody making noise, it just got quiet all of a sudden. And it was like everybody just stood up at the same time and just started running over at us. Now we're boxers. It was like 5,000 to 1. I mean, you got the Cubans, the Puerto Rican, every country.
What did you tell them, Fernando?
Yeah, what did you say, man?
Man, look, they were being disrespectful to us. They were talking
you kept it real.
About the United States, America, this, that, you know, and they were saying disrespectful things to our country. I'm representing the United States. But since I'm Mexican, and I know how to talk Spanish, and I didn't understand what they were saying, I started saying bad things back. So,
how about we had got back to America and then we would have replied back? I would have been okay with that.
So what happened? You got on the bus.
So what? No. First of all,
they're rushing.
All the security around in the whole venue had to surround us like we was Michael Jackson or something, right? They had to take us to the bus, surrounded. They throwing Molotovs. I've never seen on a movie, on PlayStation.
They trying to burn down the bus.
Dude, Molotovs at the bus, right? So we get on the bus, we got the windows up, we all down. I'm like, hold up, man. And I'm like, dude, what did you say? He was so upset, he wouldn't even tell me. It took 20 years, man. They was disrespected. So what?
Hey, we're not gonna get punked. We can't go to another country to get punked.
That's true, you're right.
Listen. Don't you know the Bible say pride is the downfall of man? Let your pride down. Let's be tough another day. Today, let's live. Yeah. You understand? So that's all I'm saying.
Right. Okay, the Bible also says an eye for an eye.
No,
it's and a tooth for a tooth.
No,
yes, but it don't say to do it right then and there in Argentina when you're surrounded by everybody from Argentina.
Let me ask both of you guys. Both of you guys are legends. Both of you guys are Hall of Famers. I got to ask you this. Mikey Garcia, Errol Spence. You know Mikey since he was born pretty much.
Well, first of all, listen. I feel like I'm part of this family because his dad, Mr. Garcia, traveled the world. Yep. You know, we slept in the same room. I can tell you how he snored. You know what I mean? I'm serious. So we go that far back, man.
Yeah.
But here's the thing, man. Those are both very, very, very good fighters, man. In my opinion, this is just my opinion. Nobody's going to lose. Yeah. You know why? Because at the end of the day, they both are going to, they're going to leave the ring with more than they ever had.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They're going to inspire younger generations, like little Fernando. You know what I mean?
So, his son's going to be a superstar already.
A beast. Well, no. Hold on.
A few of them will be superstars.
Hold on. So all we're going to have to do is make sure we're going to talk off camera.
Okay.
We got to keep this dude, in check, man.
Why is that?
Because he's a little pretty boy.
No, I'm not.
The problem is when you know you're in. Look, everywhere we went, St. Louis had girls chasing him.
That's a lie from the pit of hell.
Hey, man, you better back your camera up. His nose is going to start growing. You better back that camera up, man.
Okay. You don't know girls chase me.
Yeah, okay. Whatever.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.